Hello and welcome back. My name is Natalie Schlute, and this episode is all about claircognizance. Claircognizance means clear knowing. It's the intuitive and psychic skill of being able to receive intuitive information and psychic information through your mind, through clear knowing and understanding of something. I will be teaching you all the signs that you may have this skill set of being claircognizant, and how you can intentionally use it to become a better manifester, drawing in everything that you want to manifest into your life. If you love everything that has to do with manifestation and intuitive development, be sure that you hit the subscribe button and also hit that bell so that you get notified every time I have a new episode for you. Claircognizance means that you have a heightened sense of knowing. Clear knowing. It's when you receive psychic information as just a download into your mind. Your brain has done all the work to pick up intuitive, vibrational, energetic information from the universe, and it has pieced it all together and creates a conclusion that feels like an instant download of information. In order to truly understand your psychic abilities and your intuitive abilities, I want to start with a little bit of background to help you understand yourself as an energetic being. First and foremost, everything in our reality, everything in this universe is made up of energy. And you are an energetic being first and foremost. That means that you are connected to everything, all dimensions, everything in space, time, our reality, other dimensions, other things in existence. And your physical body is always receiving energy information and interpreting it. On a very basic level, your sense of sight, your sense of hearing, your sense of taste, your sense of touch, all of your physical human body senses are just interpretations of energetic information. Your body is receiving a piece of energy and it is transforming that into an impression, into something that you can recognize as something physical and tangible in this world. In order to develop your intuitive and psychic abilities, you are just heightening those senses that you already have. You're opening yourself up and being more aware of all the different subtle shifts on an energetic level. And that is how you are able to receive more psychic information and intuitive information. Psychic and intuitive information are the same. They're just on a varying scale of receiving and interpreting energetic information. Someone who has a higher sense of psychic ability is much more tapped into all the energetic information that they're receiving, whereas I would see someone who's a little more intuitive as just receiving impressions periodically. They are open, they just haven't honed their skill to the same level as someone who calls themselves a psychic. As a child, you are much more intuitive and more psychic, and the reason for that is because you don't have as many impressions about this physical world yet. You don't have language. You don't have these things that create limiting beliefs. But as we get older, often what happens is we are told that intuitive information or psychic information isn't real. We start to discard the information that's coming through from us, and we build these beliefs and these walls about intuition or psychic ability not being real. When in fact, that is the most solid, real thing you could experience in your life. If you have been shutting down your intuitive and psychic ability for years, that's okay. You can wake it back up. I went through my own process of kind of shutting out and not believing in the impressions that I was receiving for many years. And then through my 20s, I did a lot of inner work and I started opening myself and learning how to develop this skill set. I have a great playlist that can teach you all about how to develop your intuitive skills even further. In my mid-20s, I started working with a metaphysician and I got coaching from a psychic to help me open up my intuitive abilities and my ability to manifest things faster. I did a deep dive search into everything law of attraction, got deep into personal development, NLP, deep meditation work as well. And through the deep meditation work and then having some coaches help me to cultivate my skills, I dove deep into understanding what intuition is, how to develop your intuition. I started practicing every single day for a few years, asking my intuition questions. And now that is what I teach for a living. I have one-on-one clients. I also have an online course and a lot of other free resources like this episode here. In this episode, I'm going to be talking just about one of the clairs, But I want you to know that there are five primary clairs that many of us experience and receive psychic and intuitive information from. There's also a couple lesser ones like our sense of taste and our sense of smell. Yes, you can have psychic information come through your sense of taste and smell, but the five primary clairs that you might experience are clairvoyance, which is clear seeing, clear sight, where you experience visions. You might experience clairaudience, which is clear hearing, clear sound. You might experience claircognizance, which is clear knowing, as if someone just dropped that information straight into your mind out of nowhere. You may also experience clairsentience, which is a physical sensation where you get goosebumps on your arms, chills down your back, aches and pains in your body. And the strongest clair in most people is clairempath, your ability to sense emotions. Whether it's experiencing feeling someone else's emotions, whether it's cultivating your own emotions in order to manifest more of what you want. I experience all of these different clairs, most of them on a daily basis, but just know that some people have one clair that is a lot stronger, some people have two or three clairs that they experience. I happen to experience all of the clairs, so I can help you decipher what are your strongest clairs and how to develop those. Sometimes these clairs can come through multiple at one time. So you may have a vision, experience a feeling at the exact same time, as well as hear a message and a knowing come through. So just know that some of these come in combination. Sometimes you might experience one and not the other, but all of these psychic impressions are available to you. Claircognizance means that you have a heightened sense of knowing. People that have this skill set tend to be very logical and are very strong left brain thinkers. They love science, they love math. They tend to be the type of person that does a ton of research, that loves learning and soaking up information. They're very good at puzzles and putting things together and figuring things out naturally. This type of person naturally understands things very easily. They love watching documentaries and they love guessing the outcome of a movie, a book, a plot line. They really enjoy the guessing game of figuring out what's gonna happen next. If you are claircognizant, you have a natural ability to predict and know things before they are going to happen. You also have a great skill set of knowing things about people when you first meet them. You get impressions very quickly. You may receive flashbacks of information, but you also might receive a lot of premonitions about things that will come in the future. It was funny, the other day I was sitting at the kitchen table with my family and my sister, one of my sisters, I have four sisters, one of them put a vase of flowers on the table next to me and it was in a plastic cup. And I had this vision, like I just knew that it was gonna fall over, it was gonna fall to the right and it was gonna spill water everywhere. So I was like, wait, go take that away, put it somewhere else. Less than 60 seconds later, one of my nephews comes running down the stairs, he throws a ball into the kitchen and knocks over my glass and the water spilled in the exact direction that I saw it happening. Within 60 seconds. So sometimes we don't always have control over what impressions come through for us, and sometimes we can't avoid them, but it just goes to show how powerful the mind is. Someone who's claircognizant is really good at multiple choice games, guessing games, and has a really good memory. You have a tendency to retain a lot of information and are able to recall it very quickly. And even if you can't recall information off the top of your head, you might be the type of person like me. When you can't remember something, you just tell your subconscious mind, that's all right, you're gonna bring it up. And within a couple of minutes or a half hour, an hour, all of a sudden that piece of information is at the forefront of your mind. You're able to train your mind to pull things from your subconscious, even if you don't have the energy or the willpower to do it in that very moment. If you are claircognizant, it's extremely important that when you are attempting to manifest really awesome things into your life, that you are in a state of trusting, believing, and knowing that what you want is on its way to you. You must be so sure, so in belief that all of your manifestations are being drawn to you, and you must believe it just as much as you believe the sun will rise tomorrow, that the moon will come, that years will pass. You need to believe it so deeply that there is nothing in you that has any sort of doubt that it is on its way to you. It's very important for you to be aware of what beliefs you are holding onto that might be in contradiction to what you want to manifest. If you're really focusing on the law of attraction and there's something that you want to create in your life, whether it's finding your soulmate, creating financial abundance, or having perfect health, you may want to become aware of things that you do know for sure. Because you may have some things that you know, but they're actually not true knowings. They might actually be beliefs that you think are true, but in reality, those beliefs might be holding you back from knowing that what you want is actually on its way to you. So be very aware of your beliefs, because your beliefs are what you are manifesting, and question what you know as truth. You want to be very specific about the things you know for sure. Choose wisely. And if you really want to manifest things quickly, you must act as if it already is. Show up as the version of yourself that has already manifested the financial abundance, that has already drawn in that perfect partner. Feel love, feel abundant, feel healthy, feel wealthy. Choose to feel good every day and know that it's already yours. It is already created in the universe, and there is no separation between you and what you desire. I've created a free guide about all things claircognizance. You can download in the description below. If you love this video, please give it a like, and also let me know in the comments below if you have any questions about developing your intuition. In the next video, I'm going to be talking all about clairsentience. Be sure to subscribe and also hit that bell so that you get notified when my new episodes are released. If you absolutely loved this content, be sure to check out these videos over here, because I think you're really going to enjoy them. Let me know if there's anything else I can help you with on your manifestation journey.